Yo, 1 Below, 1 Man Army, Binary Star, Subterraneous, Breaking Records Radio. This how we represent, 110%. Let's go.
Hey, yo, it's your boy Monster Man Rocco.
It's your boy Swagger Rock.
This is Snack Ripper.
And King, you have to go, you don't know.
Master Ace, you are not rocking with the best. Breaking Records Radio.
Breaking Records, man.
Breaking Records Radio.
Breaking Records Radio.
Breaking Records.
Breaking Records.
Breaking Records Radio.
Let's go.
Breaking Records Radio.
Question 5-9. Breaking Records Radio.
Breaking Records, man. Radio is like the place to be. I don't fuck strange music, man.
Yeah, man, and so that's so back in those days too, then that's when you and Elzai would have linked up originally, right? Because you guys have worked together over the years, but you guys had him on KGB on the first album.
It's like back in those days, I would go kick it with, you know, different people in the D. Sometimes I would go build with this with Lax. Sometimes yeah. I would drive out and kick it with Elzai. Sometimes I would go, you know, we was always bumping the cats like at St. Andrews on Friday. And hanging out afterwards or whatever, but like some of those one-on-one sessions at the crib were like, you know, people would be playing like beats they was writing to, or we would be listening to Dilla beats, or we would be listening to beats like songs that, like I think a lot of those Broken Frame songs that came out later, like I had heard those when they was just on cassette tapes, so like a lot of Breakfast Club shit when
I was just
learning about Dwelle and that kind of stuff. What I'm saying is I wasn't hearing that in Pontiac, but when I would go out there, I would kick it with certain cats, and they would just be playing shit, and I wasn't even really playing a lot of music. I was just absorbing a lot, just absorbing it, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And vibing, and, you know, freestyling and just going back and forth and building. And so it wasn't really one person. It was like if you could get up and get out, like me, I had to get out to all of those spots. I had to go everywhere. I had to build with everybody. I had to go to the poetry spots. I had to go to the hip-hop spots. I went to the open mics. I went to the shows. I went to all of those spots. That's why, like, when you listen to Mo2, right, I really wanted to identify myself as all of those things. That's why, like, I had to do some poetry on there. I'm One Man Army, but I'm not always on some One Man Army battle shit. Sometimes I'm on some love shit. Sometimes I want to tell a story. Sometimes I want to just tell a story. Sometimes I just want to get really, like, abstract or whatever. And so it was really important for me to identify myself in all of those ways, but not just that, also as a producer. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.